Robert Baril, everybody. Let him hear it. And thank you. Thanks for coming out. I know it's getting dicey. Tried to get toilet paper today. Gone. Son of a bitch. So now we're stocking up on cheese. That's our big... We can keep it at bay for a while. This isn't a foolproof plan, but this is what we're going with. Wish me luck. Next time, whenever there's live comedy, I'm going to be weighing 400 pounds on stage, just at six strokes. I'm like, it worked. I didn't poop once during the entire shutdown, and then I die. You could have used Kleenex, man. You didn't have to. Some people aren't taking the virus particularly seriously. I know Kirk Cousins, Vikings quarterback, they asked him at the start of the season what his thoughts were on playing football during the pandemic. And he said, if I die, I die. Yeah, most Vikings fans were like, all right, cool, let's see what happens. All right, yeah, we got a backup, right? All right, go get him, man. Best of luck. My cousin, also like Kirk, she had not taken the virus too seriously. She's rabidly anti-mask. On their own, her family decided to boycott Walmart because Walmart, before the government stepped in, required everyone that was in their store to wear a mask, which came as horrible news to anyone that wants to be seen in a Walmart. Is that a proud moment for everybody? Is that when you want to get recognized putting that fifth box of snack cakes in your cart? Wearing your SpongeBob PJs, Robert? Ah, fuck. God damn it. I was wearing masks in Walmart before the pandemic. I didn't want to get recognized.